Booking.com basics, understanding and using restrictions. By setting restrictions, you choose which types of bookings you want to receive by controlling the search results your listing appears in. What are restrictions? Restrictions let you control the types of bookings you receive. For example, minimum or maximum length of stay, where you can specify the minimum and maximum number of nights you accept bookings for. No arrivals and departures, where you can prevent guests from checking in or checking out on specific dates. Minimum or maximum advance reservations, where you can specify the required time frame for reservations to be made, ranging anywhere between 1 hour to 1 year before check-in. When might you use restrictions? Remember that restrictions are a tool and that they should be used depending on your preferences as a host. As these might change throughout the year, we offer a variety of restriction types to potentially choose from. For example, you might be unable to prepare in time for same-day bookings or have particular dates when you're not available to offer check-in or check-out services. However, while restrictions give you more control, they also have an influence on your visibility to potential guests. How do restrictions reduce your visibility? To help understand the effects of using restrictions, let's take a look at a real-life example. Let's say someone is planning a surprise anniversary trip for their significant other and decides to look at accommodations in your area using Booking.com. They're looking for a two-night stay for the coming weekend. Their search will show them all the properties that meet their search criteria. If your property is available on their desired dates and your restrictions don't conflict with their search criteria, you will appear in their results. But if you have restrictions that don't meet what they're searching for, in this case, let's say a three-night minimum stay, when in fact they are looking for only two nights, you will not appear in their search results at all. Not appearing in search results also means guests will not be able to book a stay at your property. While in this scenario, this might be your intent, it's important to know that this is how restrictions work, by keeping you out of searches that do not meet your conditions. The unintended outcomes of restrictions. As much as restrictions can help you to intentionally control bookings, they can result in unintended outcomes as well. For instance, let's say you only have a minimum two-night length of stay restriction, so our anniversary guests from before see your property and book it for Friday and Saturday night. But what if someone else also books a stay with you from Monday to Wednesday the week after? This leaves Sunday night free, the day between your two bookings. And as you have a minimum two-night length of stay restriction, nobody can stay with you on Sunday. For that reason, when using restrictions, it's important to consider not only the direct effect that they can have, but also indirect implications that could further reduce your visibility. Having learned what restrictions are, you now know how you can use them and what their effects are. We offer a variety of tools and insights in the Opportunity Center in the extranet that can dynamically adjust your restrictions to give you the control you want while maximizing your visibility to potential guests. Setting restrictions is about finding the right balance for you. You can find tools to help you on the Opportunity Center, and you can adjust your restrictions in the Rates and Availability tab of the extranet. Visit your extranet to see what restrictions you can set up.